due to the nature of this program, listener aggression is advised.
Hey, I'm Carla.
I'm Heidi.
And we're the Butcher Babies.
This is Charlie Sheen.
Yo, what's up? This is AJ from Fire from the Gods.
This is Rich Ward, the Duke of Metal from Fozzy.
Saddam Leader from In Search of Sun.
This is Beefcake the Mighty from Guar.
And Bustulus Maximus.
Ahoy, this is Chris from Maelstrom.
Yo, what's up? This is J-Dog from Hollywood Undead.
Hi, this is Ash Costello from New Year's Day.
This is Tommy Vex from the Bad Wolves.
This is Joe from Dead.
Long last, brutality.
And I tell you now to say fucking metal, yeah.
Hey, this is Kirk from Infrared, and you're listening to Honest Brutality.
Hey everybody, this is Big Sloppy with Honest Brutality. Welcome to the show. Hanging out with my usual cohorts here today. I've got Evil and Camera Rebel. And I can't fucking talk, I swear to God.
It's weird today. Oh my God.
It's going to be a fun show. We have a Canadian on the phone with us today. Yeah. Yeah, we have awesome. Kirk Gidley from the band Infrared. How you doing, Kirk?
Great, thanks.
Glad to have you on, my friend. We caught you a day after a big show where you guys went up and hung out with Exciter last night, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
That's right. We drove 2 hours east of here to Montreal, and we caught the pioneers of thrash metal, Exciter, from our hometown.
Nice.
They've always amazed me, by the way, because they're a thrash metal band. Can't remember, I don't know if you're real familiar with Exciter.
I really am
they're
not.
They're more from the 80s, but their drummer is the singer.
Awesome.
That's right. Dan Beeler is he's an incredible. He's an incredible drummer. He just pounds the piss out of his drums and singing on top of it, which is quite amazing.
I never understood that because I always felt like, you know, drummers are inherently stupid.
Oh, but, wow.
Jesus.
Wow. No, I say that because Evil here's a drummer and I get in his ass all the time.
What's amazing?
Don't call Dan that. Have you seen Dan? He's a big dude.
No, I'll size you up before I talk shit. I'm not dumb.
What's amazing about drummers that are vocalists is that, you know, they're breathing pretty heavy behind that kit because they're just going for it. And how to maintain that and get your vocals to come through and not
it's amazing, be a mucky
mess of breath. Yeah.
Yeah. That's why you don't see many metal vocalists that are drummers. It's a rare breed and it's pretty cool to see, actually.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
And his vocal range, he hits those notes and screams, and I don't know how he does it. You can carry those screams for 10 seconds and it's like, wow.
Yeah.
I can't even count to 10.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can count to 4 though. You're a drummer.
That's all you have to do.
Exactly.
Before we get into your band, you got my curiosity because I haven't seen Exciter in 30 some odd years. Did they just do the entire album from Heavy Metal Maniac?
They did. They started off in order, did the entire album. It was amazing.
Wow.
Nice.
Wow.
Yeah.
Was there a big turnout?
Yeah, it was sold out. 500. I think that venue holds 500 people.
Nice.
It's called Le National, right downtown Montreal.
Nice. Right on, man.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's talk about Infrared a little bit. Canadian metal mother truckers. You guys have been around officially for a long ass time.
Yeah.
However,
me and my the singer / guitar player Armin, we met in high school. We had metal in common for sure. We both bought guitars at the same time. Zero lessons, of course. And I think we learned how to play guitar listening to Kill 'Em All from Metallica.
Yeah, you have a Metallica flavor for sure.
Is there a better instruction manual than the Kill 'Em All album?
There isn't, especially that Seek and Destroy with that down picking on the E.
Oh my God, yeah.
When we heard that, you know, as soon as I could do that, I was happy.
Nice.
Well, let's let the people here know what's going on a little bit. See, you formed back in the 80s, obviously, but you guys took a 27-year hiatus.
That's so amazing. Crazy.
Okay.
Well, I got out of the playing guitar. Well, not playing guitar, but I never played in bands except for Infrared. The other guys continued in bands and rock bands and different things. Our I'm still best friends with Armin, the singer, and we're actually in Mexico on vacation and with our families, and we had a few tequilas, and I said, we have to record those old Infrared songs. We only had them on cassette. Uh-huh. So we had to find that cassette and learn the songs again, and then we decided to record them.
Wow.
And, that's awesome.
Yeah, and then we released our album March 2016. And we're pretty happy with the outcome. And now we have a new album. It's recorded. Everything is done. And it's going to be out May 25th, next month. So all brand new songs.
And that album is called?
Saviours.
Saviours. Nice.
Yeah.
Well, we picked up, you put a video out for No Peace, which really good.
Yeah, it's awesome.
What I'm trying to understand here, the No Peace, is that one of the new songs or is that one of the older ones?
That's an old one. So everything that we have out right now is songs that we wrote in high school.
Oh my God.
That's so
that makes
awesome.
It that much more bitchin'.
Yeah.
Because yeah. It's a great fucking album. I was, when I got this album, because I'll tell everybody what happened. Basically, I dropped something on Facebook to have bands submit their music to be played on our radio show on Rock Rage Radio. And I had this one from Infrared, and I checked out. I said, "Holy shit, these guys are good! Mm-hmm. This got an old school flavor to it." And you put out a video to it, which is pretty cool. And I'm listening to this. I'm thinking, God, this is the album that Metallica has been trying to write again for the last 20 years. They haven't done it, and now it makes a lot of sense because if you actually wrote those and recorded them on cassette, by the way,
awesome.
Camera Rebel just doesn't appreciate that a whole lot.
Hell,
She's a little younger than we are, but back in the day, I mean, Evil and I, we remember being out, you know, trading tapes with people trying to, you know, get new music and things that way,
or just stealing them out of their car.
Speak for yourself, bro.
statute of limitations.
That's right.
So that makes it even cooler now to know that.
Growing up in Ottawa, we're pretty lucky because we had a pretty good metal scene back then. Like local bands, from our hometown is Exciter.
Yeah.
Also, Jeff Waters from Annihilators from Ottawa.
Oh, yeah.
And then we also have down the road in Toronto, you know, Anvil, Razor.
Yeah.
Who else is there? Sacrifice was a big influence on
us. Oh, wow.
I giggle because he says Anvil, and for the longest time, I thought they were a parody band. I really did. No, I know that's a total dick thing to say, but I really thought they were trying to be Spinal Tap and just joking around. I didn't realize it.
Yeah, exactly.
Legit. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really happy for Anvil. They've really come a long way the last few years. Yeah.
Boy, that documentary did them really well. You guys ought to think about doing something like that.
Yeah, that's actually a good idea.
I'm full of good ideas. I only want 10% of the take, brother. I'm good on that.
For sure. You got it.
So I want to go back to your breakup with the band real quick. So you guys broke up for 27 years. Is it all the original members of the band?
Well, now there's three of us are original. Okay. Our bass player is a fireman in Miami now. So we had to... our drummer had a friend who played bass, so three of us are the original.
Awesome.
One guy, one's new. Yeah.
Nice.
That pussy had to go fight fires instead of rock, huh? I get it.
That's right. Exactly.
So you break up, you get back together to re-record the old material. Is that what sparked wanting to write new material and get back out there?
Well, we wrote all those songs, and we just want to see what we can do now. You know, all these years later, I wasn't playing in bands, but I haven't stopped listening to metal every day since then. And we want to see what it's like to record new music, and we're very happy with it. We still have that old school sound, and I guess the songs are just, a little bit more progressive, but the same type of sound.
Well, listening to the vocals, because I'll be honest, we went back and checked out Thoughts Caught, the video for that.
I love it.
First off, the most important thing, you guys look a little different now. Just throwing that out
just
there.
Just slightly.
Just a little.
Just a little bit. But Armin's vocals sound probably better now than they did back then.
Yeah, you know what? He's been singing in rock bands just as a singer for the last 10 years before that. So he really honed in on a skill to sing. He's really taught himself, I guess.
Mm-hmm. He sounds great, but I got
over to back. Yeah, playing guitar as well.
I gotta say, did you guys become lawyers or some shit? Because the look is definitely different.
Well, you know what? We're growing our hair. It's right now, and our wives are not happy about it.
Nope. I love it.
That's awesome. So
I gotta hear it every day. Cut your hair. Cut your hair. Oh, like, you know, I'm back with my parents.
So yeah, that's cool, man. I was glad to see you guys are getting into it and growing your hair back out, getting the band back together and having fun. Obviously you guys separated 27 years ago and you had some limited success back in the 80s to some degree, huh?
Yeah, I think back then our goal as a band was to open up for bands that we like.
Oh really?
You know, yeah. Like Sacrifice. And now we're playing with bands that are, you know, that we still look up to. And it's awesome. Great playing with, you know, bands like Sacrifice and Anvil. We played with Anvil. Like, you know, it's fantastic.
Wow.
So, we did have a video for Thought Scott, and that was played on Much Music. So I guess it's like your MTV Metal Hour.
Yeah.
So that was aired on, we had a lot of mail from that video.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so we had some success, but I guess it ended quite quickly when the band split up. But it's funny you say that because we, you know, last night at Exciter, we're bumping into people, and they still remember that video. You know, all these years later, it's like once a metalhead, always awesome. A metalhead, right?
Right on, man. Right on.
Yeah.
So, let's get into that separation a little bit. Obviously, yeah. You and Armin remain friends. Was there some bitterness there that, or did life just happen and shit happens and you just...
Yeah, that's right. You know, I like going to school and jobs and it was just, you know, it's like, it's difficult to stay in a full-time band because you got to practice all the time and stuff like that, right? So, yeah, I guess what you said is, you know, like, or like we said before, life got in the way and some guys went away to school and...
Wait a second.
So that's about it, yeah.
You're telling me metalheads get educated?
Shut up.
I'm calling bullshit on that. Like exactly, I said, yeah, lawyers, right. Man. You guys look like lawyers now.
Jeez.
Yeah. I don't know about now.
So you guys got the new music out, and you got a whole new album coming out here real soon. So are you guys playing some live gigs now? What's going on?
Yeah, we have our next show is April 28th. We're opening for Flotsam and Jetsam.
Oh, get the hell out.
Okay. Yeah, in Iron Prior, which is just a small town outside of the city here.
Wow.
And we're really looking forward to that. You know, I had that album, Doomsday for the Deceiver.
Right.
You know, because it's the Jason Newsted's old band, right? Right.
Yeah. And if you've had a chance to listen to their new stuff, it's good, too.
Yeah, it was his old band, then it was his new band.
Yeah, it was old. Yeah, it's kind of similar there, right? His old new band.
It was his Infrared.
That's right. Yeah, so we're looking forward to that show, for sure.
You've been in the music industry for quite some time now.
Yeah.
What do you see as far as, like, back in the 80s versus now, the changes? What are the positives and the negatives of some of the changes that have come along?
Some of the changes is, you know, metal ruled for us in the 80s. When people talk about 80s music, I'm talking about metal.
Right.
A lot of people don't talk about 80s music, right? Because it was so big. Like, I can remember as a kid, every month there was a big show that came through town.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now we're lucky to get one a year.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, one month is Priest, and then Maiden, and then Metallica, and it's just nonstop, right?
Right, right.
And this year I've seen, you know, like, I see one or two shows a year, a big show I'm talking.
Yeah.
I just saw Judas Priest, which was fantastic.
Nice.
Unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
On the Firepower tour. But yeah, that's the biggest difference. You know, like I said, you know, metal ruled the 80s, and we were spoiled back then, I guess, right? with the amount of shows.
Mm-hmm. It's very true.
So do you think that rap and all this other kind of genres just kind of hit the scene and people grew up in that, and so that their kids grew up listening to that? Do you think that that's why that's exploded so much and metal has kind of gone by the wayside?
I think so. But you know what? Like, you get an old metal band that is still keeping the, metal flag or thrash flag alive, right?
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and the music these days, I don't know if my kids like it.
Right.
I sure don't. Yeah, I sure don't. Like, it's music without instruments, so I don't know if it's going to last. People say rock's dead, but I don't think it is.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
It's always going to... Well, yeah.
That's bullshit. Yeah.
We've been hearing that for a long time, and it's still kicking pretty hard. Yeah. So, you know.
Yeah. We're swimming in it.
Yeah. Other than a couple artists out there, the bigger draws are some of the metal tours, for sure. You look at what AC/DC could still draw, even though now, you know, I'm talking about the last year or so, they were drawing the hell out of Iron Maiden. Judas Priest, hell, they're kicking ass right now, and they sound
sure
great.
Are.
Yeah, yeah. Seeing that, but we're starting to see a little bit of a groundswell of support again, because what happened, remember, there were a lot of clubs that would play metal all the time. You'd have bands coming in. You talked about seeing shows all the time. You and I, I think, are pretty much the same age here. So I'm right with you when you talk about the 80s, brother. I mean,
only he looks way, way better.
Well, you can say that about anybody. he looks like a lawyer. I look like I need a lawyer. So
exactly.
They're like, hey, you don't have to agree with me, motherfucker.
Yeah, well, with a name like Big Sloppy, you know.
He's not going to get recognized at a yard
sale. Big Sloppy, yeah.
Oh, but anyway, we're starting to see a groundswell out here. We're actually involved. We're trying to build a scene, and what we're encouraging other areas to try to do is build that scene, go out, see live acts, go out and support the local bands, and build this metal scene back up. And we're starting to see it. We're working with some guys here in Northern California that are trying to make that happen, and we're starting to see it. More and more people starting to show up to the shows again. We're finding avenues for them to play and different venues and things. It's starting to come back a little bit, I think.
Yeah, for sure. And you see a lot of bands, like I mentioned before, Ottawa bands like Exciter, Annihilator.
Mm-hmm.
They do play a lot, but it's in Europe and South America where it's metal rules still. Yeah. Or I think it always has.
Yeah.
But that's where these bands have to go. And it's kind of sad, like they can't tour North America like they used to.
Yeah.
I think, but as you said, it's hip hop or rap that rules right now, right?
Yeah, and I don't get it, but you know, here I am, 50 years old. I'm probably not going to get it.
Well,
and that's okay.
I'm way younger than you, and I just don't get it.
Yeah.
I prefer, and you mentioned it actually. It's music without instruments, which I don't get at all. That's not music. That's sound, and there's a big difference, I think.
Because anyone can plug in their phone, right, and play music at a club. Like, I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't either. I don't either. I don't see how guys that are, quote, DJs make it real big by mixing their beats. Well, play a fucking drum set, then we'll talk, you know? You know, show me some beats.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't get it.
So are you guys working on any more videos?
We have two videos we're going to make. We're actually on April 28th. We're shooting a video, and we sent a message out on Facebook for extras. So what we're doing is we're shooting a video in an old factory, a Nestle chocolate factory that's abandoned.
Nice.
And we're going to have people, we're going to be playing, and we're going to have people come in and participate in the video. More like a crowd, right?
Yeah. Nice. I love it.
That'll be interesting.
Yes. Right?
Are you handing out free chocolate bars at the end?
Yeah, it's going to be a basic video. Yeah. That's right. Well, I don't know about chocolate bars.
They're all like...
how about some brownies?
They're Canadian. It'll be beer, right? It'll be beer. Yeah.
Yeah, there'll probably be lots of beer.
You say probably. I say for sure.
I say that's worth a passport stamp. Head up there.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
I'm going to have to let me back in.
A second video as well.
You know, speaking of videos, this last video that you did... it's a lot of fun. It's really cool. Did you guys do this all in-house? Did you have somebody come in and help you?
Well, I have a friend of mine, James Ramsey from Skytography. He did all the filming, and that was his very first video, No Peace.
Oh, really?
So that was something new for him, yeah. So he's doing our next, too.
Yeah, we were loving the old rundown house.
Oh, my gosh.
That
looks so cool.
I'm a photographer, and I was just looking at it. I'm going, oh, I want in there so bad.
Yeah, we found that old house, and it was all boarded up, so we kind of snuck in there. And
hey, wait
Rebels.
A second.
Rebels.
I thought that place looked familiar.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say it was the drummers.
Exactly. Yeah. That old house. It was about 25 below here that day, so it was pretty cold.
Wow. Amazing. Wait,
you're telling me it gets cold in Canada?
Sometimes, yeah. All right. Very cold this year.
So you were talking about the metal scene as you were growing up, and it was very active. And so what is it like now? What does that metal scene look like? What does the live music scene look like right now up there?
Well, in Ottawa, we have a pretty healthy music scene, and lots of good local bands and young bands coming up. It's funny, you know what? They have all those patches on their jackets, right? Because they got that battle vest.
Yeah.
And they're all the bands that, you know, that we grew up with. It's cool to see, you know, teenagers loving the same music we grew up with. So,
yeah, it's funny you should say that, because we see that a lot, and I think it's really super cool. I really get a kick out of seeing these young kids, you know, that are still sporting Slayer patches.
Yeah.
You know, that's old school.
Right on.
You know, one I see a lot that I don't get, because I don't think anybody really listens to them, is Saxon patches, because their patches look so bitchin'.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, I just saw Saxon. They're awesome. They Judas Priest here.
That's right. They're opening. Yeah, yeah. Biff still sounds good, man. Those guys, they're getting it
very
done.
Good. Yeah. Very impressed. I was looking at these guys like, wow, old are these guys?
I know, right? Well, yeah, I've never been a huge Saxon fan. I love Denim and Leather. I love Princess of the Night. And after that, they kind of lost me. But they sound, you know, they're professionals. They get out there and kick ass. They work their ass off on stage. You got to admire that. I'm getting crusty in my old ears, and these guys remind me of it all the time.
Absolutely. Yeah,
always
that's
in my
job.
Ass about my age. But
it's your attitude.
It's not your age.
And the truth shall set you
free. Why do you say that? You know, like we played quite a few shows in town.
Uh-huh.
And one of our very first gigs, you know, like we'll be opening for so-and-so comes in town, and it'll be four openers, right?
Right.
So we're like, you know, second, third, or fourth, or whatever, to open up for the band. And I remember rolling in there in our minivans with our equipment and helping, or, you know, lugging our equipment into the bar. And the other band's thinking, we're the parents of the band.
I was going to say, he's got a car seat full of microphones.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so we're like rolling in Marshalls and guitars, and they're like, oh, sir, can I help you? Where's the band? They're like, dude, I am the band.
Oh, my God, that's hilarious.
That sucks.
Yeah. We had this one band, because like, they thought we were the parents. And then they said, what do you guys play, country? And then we got up and blew them off the stage.
Perfect.
Fucking whippersnappers. Kiss my ass.
Yeah. After we played, they said, sorry, man.
Good.
I didn't know.
Good.
That'll teach. Let the metal do the talking.
Right.
Awesome. Well, now we got Armin, our singer, probably won't like this, but we use that shampoo Control GX to get the gray out. So I was thinking of contacting as a Menon or Control GX, whatever it is, and we could do a commercial for it.
There you go.
It could sponsorship.
Be your official sponsor.
Oh my god.
Yeah, before and after, you know.
No, make a good commercial. I could see this. We're sponsored by on your line card, you can say you're sponsored by Zildjian, Jackson, and
Ensure.
Yeah.
It depends. Viagra.
Oh,
hey man.
Yeah, Viagra, everyone needs those too.
Yeah, right.
A drummer, he won't do it. Our drummer won't do it. You'll see on our new pictures, we're all got dark hair except for our drummer who refuses to use it. And I bought him a bottle for Christmas and he didn't use it.
That's awesome. I love it.
So it sounds to me like you guys are jokesters with each other. Obviously you get along very well. You guys like to prank each other a lot?
Oh yeah, all the time. It's not serious, right? That's why we're doing this. It's fun.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a lot of fun, and we love. We're really anxious to, you know, get a reaction from this album here. So it's going to be out soon, and it's kind of fun now. We got more songs to play, right?
Absolutely. Just
one album.
That's the same old thing.
Okay, so I got to ask this question: when you guys first got back together, you decided you're going to redo the old songs and record them right and get them on, you know, digital and whatnot. How hard was it for you guys to go back and relearn those songs?
It was very difficult. I had everything. I'm a more of a visual guy, so I tabbed it out, right?
Uh-huh.
And I had it written down on a piece of paper, and I would just tack it on the wall when we're were jamming. And I just kind of followed along with my own notes. It kind of made sense. And, you know, after a few months, the notes went away, right?
So, right.
But not playing in a band, like, you know, it was quite difficult, you know. Some of her songs, like Thoughts Caught, I had a really hard time playing. But now it's, you know, just through muscle memory and playing live shows and preparing, it's much easier.
Yeah.
It's that right hand, all that picking and triplets. And it was just like, I guess it's just like anything else, like sports, right?
Right.
Yeah, you gotta practice, practice, and when you're done practicing, do more practice. Yeah, that's the way it works if you want to stay sharp.
Yeah.
Well, that's interesting. So I want to know where you guys found a cassette player to play the old music.
They probably still had one.
I didn't have one.
It was the drummer.
Well, yeah, exactly.
Oh, he's gonna be pissed.
Well, it's funny now, you know, like,
love it.
We're selling our merch at our shows and CDs, and the kids want cassettes now.
What?
Really?
Yeah, like a lot of the bands now are selling cassettes.
Wow.
Retro.
Really?
I knew the vinyl was out there. I had no clue that the cassette thing was taken off
again. That's
exciting. I'll tell you what, they don't know what a mistake they're making.
Now, if they want to make a mistake, they'll start collecting 8-tracks.
Right, that's when
they know they're going retro.
That's when a pencil is your best friend.
Yeah.
Get that pencil out.
That's a bad idea, guys. Let me tell you.
Yeah.
So let's talk a little bit more about the new album that you're working on.
Okay.
What are we looking at here? How many songs are we looking at? How far along are we?
It's everything's done. We just got back from mastering. And we're not going to release it until we finish our first video. So we've picked the date of May 25th. So there's 8 brand new songs. And they're all long, between 6.5 to 8 minutes.
Oh, so you guys really are Metallica fans.
How many times can you write Creeping Death, for God's sake?
No. Well, you know, I missed that, though. There was the day of the epic metal tune. So mm-hmm. back in the late 80s, early 90s, that was commonplace for a metal song to be
absolutely
no less than 5 minutes and up to 8 or 9.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And now it's, and like, 4 minutes you're
that's
out.
That's right. And we didn't mean to, we didn't do that intentionally. It just, you know, after we wrote them and recorded them, we're like, holy crap, you know?
Yeah.
There's no songs that are 5 minutes. Like you said, they're all long.
I think that's one of the reasons metal has a hard time getting on the radio, because the good songs, you want to build a story through your song, basically.
Well, because the attention span of the listener is all dumbed
and down. It's always been that way. The reason they dumbed them down to 3 and 4 minutes was to get them on the air.
Yeah,
basically,
because of ADD. It's rampant.
That's right.
So what are we talking about influence-wise? Did anything change? Did you add new stuff? What happened there?
I don't think anything's really changed. I think the songs are just a little bit more progressive, I guess. A little bit more complex. As soon as it's released, you'll get a copy.
We cannot wait.
Hey, look, Mother Trucker, I don't think you know who you're talking to here.
Shut up.
If I don't have a copy by the end
stupid.
Of the day.
God.
This may never make the air.
Hey,
I'm just saying.
What, how about you send him a bottle of that shampoo first?
I will. Control GX.
You got any sort of control for his mouth? That would be a wonderful product, too.
Now, Jesus Christ.
On your bio, you guys cite the Big Four, obviously, as your primary influences.
Yep.
So I want to put your feet to the fire here. Of the Big Four, which one's your favorite?
Well, Metallica. I know that's not trendy. A lot of people are hating on them for some reason lately. I don't know what it is, but growing up in the 80s, with those albums they put out in the 80s, like, even if they had stopped making albums after Injustice, they'd still be my favorite band.
There you go. So that was going to be my next question. If Metallica is your favorite of the Big Four, which album? What's the best Metallica album in your opinion?
Well, I'm going to say Master of Puppets, but I think the one that had the biggest influence on me was Kill 'Em All, for sure, when it first came out.
Nice.
When I heard like I mentioned earlier, you know, I first heard Seek and Destroy with that, almost sounded like a chainsaw back then, because there's no other guitars mm-hmm. were that distorted, right?
It's right, just, yeah.
You know, I loved Priest and Maiden and Sabbath, but then this, when I heard this over-distorted guitar, just the way James, with his rhythm, it was just like, wow. And that's what made Armin and I go by. We went and bought guitars because of that album.
That's awesome right there.
I love it.
Yeah.
That is
cool. We went
cool.
down to the local music store, and we each bought a Flying V.
Oh, nice.
I love it.
I got the white one, and he got the red one. And that was it. We started Infrared. And the first riff I wrote was No Peace.
Beautiful.
Our very first song.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
What are some of the things that you do besides music?
Well, I guess just like any Canadian kid, is play hockey. Play a lot of hockey.
You still have your teeth?
I do.
Awesome.
That means he's not I've always kept my teeth off.
If he's got all his teeth, means he's not a good hockey player.
he takes them out before he plays.
That's right.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And I don't wear a helmet, right? I show off my hair.
Yeah, that's right. Helmets are for pussies. You know that.
Oh, that's funny.
Amazing.
That's right.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Hockey. Yeah, that's right. You guys do a lot of that up there. You know, it's surprising we don't have like hockey metal shows. That would be rad, right? Like a band in the middle of the ice.
It would be.
You know?
Can you imagine that mosh pit? Oh my God.
It was slipping, sliding.
Every hockey game I go to, they're always playing metal, you know?
That's true.
Beautiful.
That's one place that you can go to and hear heavy metal. A hockey game.
That's what you guys need to do, is like do a video in the middle of a hockey rink with all your...
Yeah. Have a mosh pit on the ice.
Oh my God.
Yeah. I'd love to get our song, you know, like you always hear the same songs. Like when you're watching it on TV or you're at a game, they're always playing, Metallica or Black Sabbath, Ozzy.
Right.
Songs in between, during the whistle, after the whistle. Right.
Yeah.
That'd be a dream of mine, is to have one of our songs played.
I was going to say, there's
you know,
your goal.
One of these hockey games.
Well, all you got to do is find the sound guy there in Ottawa for a Senators game and
slip him a fiver.
Hey, man.
Hand him your cassette.
Here you go. It is amazing with the strength of the hip hop world and the influence they have, that it is the metal and rock that is considered the go to get them going kind of step music for hockey, even football. You'll hear Crazy Train a lot and things of that ilk.
Hockey is pretty much a giant mosh pit on skates.
It kind of is.
Really?
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to watch more hockey.
And I remember as a kid in our dressing room, we'd be playing Metallica before we went on the ice, you know, feeding us raw meat and listening to Metallica.
Wow.
Well, some of those guys had to have the raw meat put in a blender first because they did not have the teeth to chew it.
Exactly. So, yeah, they go hand in hand. Hockey and metal go hand in hand for sure.
So you guys are all, you're older now, but you're back together. You're doing this thing. You're writing some music, and you've all got families. Are you you dragging your kids along to the shows? You bringing them with you?
Yeah, my son pretty much goes to every show. He's a guitar player as well.
Oh, nice.
He's actually a very, very good guitar player.
Really?
Way better than I am.
Yeah, that usually happens, damn kids. Bastards.
Yeah, he can just play anything. And on solos, I'm not much of a, I'm more of a rhythm player. And I'm walking around the house and I hear him playing these complex, Randy Rhodes solos note for note. And I'm like, what the hell? Where did he get that from?
YouTube.
Yeah. Exactly.
They have tools that we didn't.
Yeah, it is a big difference now with the access those kids have to the interweb now to seek out and learn different shit is amazing.
Yeah, I remember with the cassettes, right? And hit play and listen and then try and play it. That's all we had, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And that's how we learned.
Until that tape wore out.
Do you remember like you always coveted the tape player that had the counter so you could rewind it to the spot you wanted?
Yes, you remember that? Yes, I do.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yep. I remember Riot Swords of Tequila was 54 clicks. How the hell do I remember that? Jesus Christ, that was 1982 for crying out loud.
I don't know. You almost forgot to come here today.
I remember recording music from cassette player to cassette player.
Until they come out with the dual ones, and that was awesome.
Speaker to microphone. Flip one over.
I don't know if it was a thing in Canada or not, but where I was, you would buy the vinyl because of the cover art and the sleeve, all the inserts and everything, and then you would record that because you had a stereo that you could record your album to the cassette. I actually had one I can't believe I'm admitting this. I had one I could record the album to an 8-track.
Oh my God. You are old.
Yeah, my dad.
High tech.
My dad had one of those.
Oh, fuck.
Go shave your head. Yes. 10 points for Kirk.
You must have a wide foot because you got both of them. Jesus Christ, that hurt.
Hell yeah. Oh, I love fun. It. Thank you.
My dad.
Oh, God, that would hurt. When did you say the new album's going to drop?
May 25th.
Okay, so right in time for Memorial Day weekend here in the States. That's good stuff. We have something to listen to over the weekend. Anything else you wanted to talk about that we didn't touch on?
I'm looking forward to releasing this album, get some feedback. You know, when you're recording something, you're so close to it and no one's really heard it. And we're really looking forward to some feedback, for sure.
This has been our boy, Kirk Gidley from the band Infrared out of Ottawa, Canada. Had a good time hanging out with you today, buddy. Thanks for coming out and spending your Sunday, I guess afternoon where you're at, morning where we are, with us and having a good time.
Thanks, guys.
Where can the people find you?
We're on Facebook, Infrared, or we have a website, infraredmetal.ca, and Infrared, we're also on Instagram.
All right. As Hoser's hanging out with a Canadian, eh?
What a cool guy.
It was a lot of fun. Yeah, that was interesting, you know, see a band that was around a long time ago. Life happened, got back together, putting out some kick-ass music.
Amazing.
I love it.
We spend a lot of time working with bands from all over the world, mm-hmm. and we spend time with bands that are up and coming.
Right.
So it's really pretty cool to get with a band that has already been there, done that, and right. they're back out there.
Yeah.
It's kind of a new thing for us, too.
Yeah. I think this is... I don't want to say it's the first time we've had something like this, but it's the biggest gap I think we've seen with the band that we've dealt with in the past. So, yeah, it's pretty cool, man.
Yeah, he was a fun guy, definitely.
Yeah, real nice guy.
I just love it when he's, like, jabbing you.
I think freaking he jabbed amazing. Me and didn't know it.
Yeah. Well, no, that's Canadian for you. They're polite. So.
There you have it.
Anyway. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in and listening. We really appreciate it. The band was Infrared. Get over and check them out. Give them some love. I think they said they were on Facebook and Instagram. Those are respectively the two biggest socials.
And their
you
website.
Can find
yep.
And their website, which was infraredmetal.ca. If you're listening on iTunes or anywhere else, please do us a favor and go over and give us a rating. We want some stars. We don't really care about the review. You can write whatever you'd like. Just say hi. Tell us about your mom's favorite cat. I don't know. Whatever. And that really doesn't matter. It just matters that we get stars. We don't understand how it works. We just know that we like the shiny things. So please do that for us if you will. You can also check us out at honestbrutality.com. Find out what's going on with all the different festivals, stages, things we have coming up, and the rest of the podcast episodes are over there. You can also find our radio show times, respectively. Yeah. You can reach out to us. All the mail links are there. Mm-hmm. And you can also give us a call.
Yeah, which if you would, please give us a verbal star, 530-962-0411. Again, that's 530-962-0411. We'd love to hear from you.
Be good people. Take care of one another. And most importantly,
stay metal!
Stay metal.
This is Kirk from Infrared. This is No Peace off our debut album. And you're listening to Honest Brutality.
Favor! mistakes or all the years of force and abuse. Examples made sadistic ways to show them what's to lose. The people have spoken, the end of their reign. Hanging on the ropes, there's nothing left to gain. A new world order for the common man. A thing the filthy rich can fucking understand. Their way breeds hate and brings their own demise. From the ashes of the rich, the weak will rise.
Rise! All in favor!
Hey everybody, welcome to Honest Brutality. This is Big Sloppy, Joan, one of my usual cohorts. We got,
what did you
Joan
just say?
Joan by Mike?
I sound like
that?
I was fucking hammered. I'm going to do this again. Scratch.
Jesus Christ.
Take two. Joan, I think I went and saw Exciter last night. Holy shit. Hold on a second.
Who's Joan Mobile?
God damn.
It's awesome.
Right out the fucking gate.
This is Joan Mobile.
I got everything roughed up. All right, try it again. there's going to be a lot of this, Kirk, just so you know.
you're so stupid.
All right, let's try it again. Take two.
All right.